The Willamette is one of the few major rivers in the United States that flows primarily north. So narrow and shallow in places that pioneers could fell trees for bridges. It also widens to more than 2,000 feet across as it passes through the city of Portland. Originally, the river meandered a wide swath across the Willamette Valley floor, changing channels frequently to form new islands and oxbows. Today, the Willamette is rather tame in comparison. While commercial tugs and barges navigate its locks to move chips and log, gravel, sand, and other products to market, and huge freighters and ocean-going barges move tons of cargo through the port of Portland and the private docks in Portland Harbor, today recreation is the fastest growing use of the river. Pleasure boating, skiing, and angling have increased over the years. Portland, Lake Oswego, Salem, Albany, Corvallis, Harrisburg, Eugene, Springfield are just some of the cities and towns that have greatly increased their parkland and public access along the Willamette's 180-mile shoreline. The Willamette's within 20 miles of 70% of the people who live here in Oregon. The river's been so shallow this year that it can only support flat-bottom sailboats, sailboards, and some kayaks. That's the Portland Spirit. It's just one of the many tour ships that travel the Willamette. It's a 150-foot yacht with three decks, two of which are closed. The ship has a special designed hull so it can travel in only 6 feet of water, which makes it ideal for the Willamette during the low tide. Kayaks are ideal for exploring the many small islands on the Willamette River, or just paddling through the many communities of houseboats that are out here.